Let us all read together this one verse. But the word of God increased and multiplied. Amen. Let us bless each other, be at peace. You guys are the missionaries to save the world. Let us receive the inheritance of the desolate heritages. Hallelujah. You and I are the people who are inside of the eternal covenant. It is our lives that are inside of the covenant journey. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May the blessing of God that never changes be upon you at this time of worship. He broke the forces of darkness and he set us free from sin and Christ that has come to us as life. I bless you in the name of the Lord again. May you be filled with that Christ at this worship time. Last week, we shared the message with the title, Those Who Are Still in Midst of Prayer. It means do not stay inside of your thoughts, but stay inside of prayer. And even now, the people who are still inside of prayer, everything will become an answer to them. This one pastor said to me, he said, this one pastor that gave this word, and he is now in heaven, but what did he said was, prayer is not a spare tire, it is the handle. So what is prayer? It's not a spare tire. But most of the people use prayer as a spare tire. So you guys all have a spare tire inside of your trunks, and when the tire has a hole, we change it. Just like that, we pray when we are faced with a problem. So it's not that kind of prayer. We must go inside of prayer, holding on to everything. We must not lose hold of this even once. If you're not in the midst of prayer inside of your life, even now, everything will seem to you as a problem. You must be able to enjoy that as an answer, but because you see that as a problem, you fall into the problem.
And
I really hope that you and I become the person who really enjoy the answers that God gives us inside of prayer. And today's title is An Evangelist in the Work of God's Word. It is the evangelists who are inside of the work of God's Word. And many of the people say that, they're not able to pray and they're not able to evangelize. And they say the Word of God is not being fulfilled inside of my life. And they keep on thinking that there are no answers to their prayers and there is no works of God that arises inside of their lives. But the fact that you are inside of that thought are being deceived. So we must discard those thoughts. If you see in Ecclesiastes 3:11, it says he has made everything beautiful in its time. It says beautiful in its time. Also, he has put eternity into man's heart. Yet, so that he cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. So what this means is that there is the plan and the time schedule of God in everything.
우리 자신의 기준으로 신앙생활을 하고 하나님을 바라봐.
But most of the people, they live their walk of faith and they look towards God with holding on to their own standards.
금요일 우리 기도회 전에 농아부에서 나와서 특송을 했습니다.
So we had the
매주 금요
blind and deaf
도구별로
a department come out and give praise.
지난주에는 농아부에서 나와서 특송을 했습니다.
So we have this time of special praise that is given by each of the departments inside of the church. And last week was the blind and the deaf people. They were giving praise with sign language. So they were doing the sign language and we saw and inside of the praise, there is a lyric that says, "My thoughts are, God's thoughts are greater than my thoughts."
가장 완전한 길로 오늘도 날 이끄심을 믿는다.
And I believe that God leads me to the path that is best for me.
은사와 부르심에는 후회하심이 없다라고 말씀하셨죠.
So if God calls us, He has no regrets on calling us.
다른 분들이 불러도 찬양의 은혜가 되었을 것이지만은 사실 농아부가 나와서 그 찬양을 하니까 현장을 보여 현장과 함께 가사들이 새롭게 마음에 담겨지는 것이었습니다.
So if other people came out and gave that praise, it would be a time of grace. But
내 생각보다 크다.
The blind and the deaf people came out and the sign language and there is the greater will of God on calling us. So it had a great meaning inside of it. So the plans that God has planned for me, I cannot condemn. And what is most important is that I still believe that God is leading me. So if you're faced with the problem and if you're not in midst of prayer, it's the confession that we cannot give. This is the confession that we are able to give when we are able to know that in all things God is guiding me. If you see in Hebrews 11, there are the people of faith. But there is a passage that is always put. It says, in faith.
우리는 하나님의 언약을 붙잡고 믿음으로 도전하는 그때에 하나님의 역사를 보게 되는 것입니다.
So when we hold on to the covenant of God and in faith, when we challenge, we are able to see God's plans. So do not, in whatever the circumstances, do not fall into unbelief, but really hold on to and choose faith. When we're faced with this kind of situation and that kind of problem, so we have no choice but to fall into unbelief. But if you fall into unbelief, it's a loss to us. So let's only choose holding on to faith.
우리 신앙생활 가장 중요한 것이 매 순간 순간마다 믿음으로 하나님 앞에 서는 것입니다.
So as we are walking the walk of faith, what is most important is standing before God in faith.
하나님의 계획과 시간표가 있다라는 사실.
Because in all things there is the time schedule and the plans of God.
우리의 삶은 역사와 응답 이전에 나와 함께 하시는 그리스도를 누리는 것입니다.
And the life of the disciples before answers and works.
지금도 나와 함께 하시는 그리스도 임마누엘의 축복이죠. 이 축복이 응답이.
We are enjoying that God is with us. So Emmanuel, this is what we enjoy, and this is our answer and the works of God. Inside of this, we are able to see the work of the Holy Spirit, and we are able to see the true hopes of God.
나만의 기도의 시간들 통해서. 날마다 임마누엘을 누릴 수 있어야 합니다.
And through the individual and the personal prayer time, you must enjoy Emmanuel.
기도 속에 있다면은 여러분 날마다 모든 것들이 축복으로 응답으로 누려지고 세상을 변화시키는
So if you're still inside of the mystery of prayer, and if you're enjoying this, then you're going to become the person to change the world. In today's passage, you're able to see that how God protects the evangelists that are still inside of the mystery of prayer. If you're truly the evangelist, do not be fooled and deceived by the difficulties that come to you. You must see correctly. If you see in the Bible, you're able to see the Jewish people block the spread of the gospel, but this gospel was being spread. We haven't read today, but you're able to see King Herod, he kills James, the Apostle James. And it was a strategy to block the spread of the gospel. Herod, because he was a politician, he had to gain the hearts and the popularity from people. So that is why he captures Peter and puts him inside a prison. And he had a plan on killing Peter after the days of the unleavened bread and the Passover. And that is why he had the guards to guard Peter. And now the early church was faced with this great crisis, and Peter was also in front of death. But if you see in verse 6 today, you're able to see that on that very night, Peter was asleep. So it was a time where he must be in fear and in anxiety, but he fell asleep.
And
to the point where the angel of the Lord had to come and strike his side to wake him up. So he was not afraid of death. You're about to be put to death tomorrow, and on that very night, can you fall asleep? But you're able to see Peter, he was sleeping to the point where the angel had to come and strike him on the side to wake him up. Right now, it is an age where there are no peace. And right now, we are living in an age where persecutions and hardship is continued to come our way. But how can we have victory inside of this kind of age? Those people who are inside of the mystery of prayer and enjoying Emmanuel, that kind of problems is not a problem to them. If you see in the Bible and church history, to all of the evangelists, there were persecutions and hardships that came their way. And the representative figure was Paul. And if you see in 2 Corinthians 11, you're able to see. Verses 23 through 27, it tells us what kind of hardship did this Peter face. It says he was
40에서 감한 매를 하나 감한 매를 다섯 번 맞았고요.
He was whipped.
세 번 태장으로 맞았고요. 한 번 돌로
And he was stoned.
돌로 맞았고요. 그리고 세 번 파선하고 일주일 깊은 바다에서 지냈다 했습니다.
And he says, three times he was bitten with a rod. Once I was stoned. Three times I was shipwrecked. A day and night I was drifted at sea. And in verse 26 it says, on frequent journeys, in danger from river, dangers from robbers, danger from my own people, danger from Gentiles, danger in the city, danger in the wilderness, danger at sea, danger from false brothers, in toil and hardship, through many a sleepless night, in hunger and thirst, often without food, in cold and exposure. So Paul lived a life where most of the people do not want to live. The hardships that people do not want to face continuously came to Paul. But Paul was a person still only boasting about Christ, and he was a person who was held by the words of God. In Acts 18:5, it says, Paul was occupied with the word. When we are held by the word, then we become the people who can win over any persecutions and hardships. Because persecution and hardships are not the problem. It is because we do not have the Word of God inside of us as a covenant. That is why when we are faced with the persecution and the hardship, that seems like a problem to us. So let us become the people like Paul who's occupied by the Word. When we hold on to the word and head out to the world, we are able to see that we are the people who are occupied by the word. And we are able to know that there is the hidden plans of God inside of those persecutions. If you see in Isaiah 55:8, it tells us, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways. It says, declares the Lord. And in verse 9, it tells us, for as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways. And my thoughts than your thoughts. So what was the reason Apostle James was martyred? And what was the reason why Peter was put to prison? It was the hidden plans of God to reveal that his plans are being still continued and fulfilled. Yes, we can face persecution and hardships. Yes, we can be faced with a problem. But there is no reason for us to fear. Because we are inside of the process where God's plans are being fulfilled. And that is why we must see accurately. We must not be deceived, and we must see accurately. To the people of Christ, in all of the problems, there is the guidance of God and there is the plans of God that are hidden inside of those problems. When we hold on to the gospel and go out to preach the gospel, there are problems that we will face. And it tells us in the book of Matthew, the time of the end days. But even in the midst of those problems, do not be deceived. Because that is not the end, because the end will come when the gospel is preached to the ends of the earth. So do not be deceived by all of the process that you are going on. And finding all of the plans of God inside of all of the problems and hardships, I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you find all of the blessings. Secondly, we must become the person of faith who believes in the work of God. We must not be deceived, but see accurately and become a person of faith who believes in the work of God. If you see in verse 6 today, God sends his angels. And broke the shackles, the chains that Peter was bound by.
시내로 통하는 문에 세 문에 인도되었다라고 10절에 말하고 있습니다.
And he, the angel, leads Peter out of prison.
근데 정신을 차려 보니까 하나님이
led him to the city.
구원하심을 깨닫게 되었습니다.
And when he came back to his senses, and he was able to realize that God sent his angels to rescue him. He first thought this was a vision. But when the angels come and was at work, if you see in verse 5, so Peter was kept in prison, but earnest prayer for him was made. And if you see in verse 12, when he realized this, he went to the house of Mary, the mother of John, whose other name was Mark, where many were gathered together and were praying. So when they were praying, God sent the angel to Peter and led Peter all the way out to the city. It tells us when we pray, the angel of the Lord are mobilized. So people were praying, but as answer, God sent the angel. It doesn't tell us how many days that they prayed.
당장 응답을 주신 것이 아니라 계속 기도를 하도록 하시면서 헤롯이 죽이려고 하는 그 전날 밤에 천사를 보내신 사실을 보게 돼요.
God didn't send the angels right away when they started to pray. They prayed. God made the people pray continuously.
그 전날 밤에
And
천사들이 움직였다라는.
The day before when Herod was trying to kill Peter, that is when God answered.
하나님이
Why is that? It is showing that God is the one who answers, and that is why we must see that accurately. If you see in Ezekiel
36:37, and in
verse 38, And they, the flocks will know that I am the Lord. So God gave the message of restoration of Israel. And God told them to hold on to this and pray. And through that, God will make you known that I am the God that gives you the answer. But most of the people did not believe that Peter came out of the prison.
Jode라는 아이가 베드로의 음성을 듣고 기쁨으로 얼른 돌아가서 소식을 전하게 되었죠.
And this one child heard the voice of Peter and came back.
소식을 듣고 사람들의 반응이 어떠했습니까? 13절 15절에 보면
This servant girl named Rhoda
천사라고 했습니다. 그러다가 베드로를 보고 놀란 것이죠.
And they said the servant girl has gone crazy. But this servant girl, Rhoda, she said that it was the angel of Peter. And they were able to see Peter. So it tells us God mobilizes his angels to answer our prayers. There are times when God answers right away. Today you're able to see right before King Herod was trying to kill Peter, that is when God answered, but there are times when God answers right away.
And
if you see in the book of Daniel, you're able to see that God shows great vision to Daniel that there will be a great war that will arise.
큰 은총을 입은 사람 다니엘이라 부르셨어요. 그러면서 하나님께서 네게 전달할 말씀이 있어서 내가 왔다라고 이야기했어.
And this one person came to Peter, Daniel, and said,
that
"I have been sent."
하나님께서 이미 너의 기도에 응답하셨다 말씀하고 있어.
By the Lord, And it says, on the first day you were in prayer, that is when I was sent.
그러나 시간을 두고 정확한 때에 하나님께서 시간표를 가지고 우리에게 응답하시는 경우가 있습니다.
So there are times when God answers us right away, but in His time schedule, He answers us. It's not our thoughts, but it is the thoughts of God in His plan with the most greatest thing and the most peaceful way He will guide us. So last week we had a time to share the message. Now the Israelites were about to be put to death by the person name of Haman.
그런데 그때에 에스더가 전 백성으로 말미암아 기도하게 하면서 기도를 선포하게 되죠.
But at that time, through Esther, you're able to see that she asked the people to pray, pray for her. Through Mordecai, who said, isn't this the time that God has prepared you? And hearing that, Esther said, then all of the people of Israel pray for me. Pray for me the 3 days of fasting prayer. And she goes off, and on that night, King wasn't able to sleep. And he was walking around the palace, and he found this book. And he saw this book, and he read the book. Inside of the book, he was able to see the Mordecai help his people. Because the king wasn't able to sleep, he was reading a book, and he saw that Mordecai did good things for his people, and that was recorded in the book. So if God would even reveal the hidden things to give us answers. And now Joseph goes to prison. You're able to see he was able to share this dream. So because of that dream, Joseph stood in front of the king. You're able to see that we are in midst of prayer and we forget that prayer, but God will reveal that prayer again inside of our lives as answers. And Abraham was faced with the war, but he built an altar. So it was a time. He was a person of worship.
But
Lot chose the Sodom and Gomorrah that seemed pleasing to the eyes. And now a war broke out, and it was a war that had no relation with Abraham. But Abraham, through that war, he was able to become rich. And it was a war that had no relations with Lot, but it brought failure to Lot. So we cannot understand how God will answer us. There's a time when He answers us right away, but there are times that He leaves time space. In the most accurate time schedule, in His plan, God will answer us. Mobilizing the angels, He will answer all of our prayers.
오늘 하나님의 뜻이 성취되도록 천사를 보내신 사건이 오늘 본문에 나오죠.
In today's passage, you're able to see to answer the prayer, God sends His angel.
헤롯을 꺾으신 것입니다.
And breaks down King Herod, who was trying to block the gospel.
지금도 하나님은 하나님의 말씀을 이루기 위해서 하나님의 뜻을 성취하기 위해서
Even now, God to fulfill His word and to fulfill His will, He's mobilizing the angels. You guys all know the book of Psalms. In Psalms 103, verse 20, the angels hear the voice of His word. And you're able to see that angels are mobilized.
14장 19절입니다. 이스라엘 백성들이 홍해에 들어갔습니다.
So
그때 이스라엘 백성들 앞서 행하던 주의 사자가 이스라엘 백성 뒤로
The Israelites 옮겨졌단 말이에요. In Exodus goes inside of the Red Sea and you're able to see the angel that was working and guiding the Israelites were in back of them.
기도하기 시작했어. 온갖 수단과 방법을 동원하면서 나아가다가 결국은 손 들고 하나님 앞에 하나님 바라보며 기도하기 시작했어.
And there was this great war that arose, and King Hezekiah, he was using his humanism, but later on, you're able to see he kneels down and looks towards God, and at that very moment, the angel of the Lord was mobilized and killed 48,000 soldiers, or 480,000 soldiers. So, when we pray, God hears our words or our prayers by sending the angels, and God answers us, sending the answers.
기도할 때마다 일어나는 영적인 역사를 사실적으로 붙잡기를 바랍니다.
Really, hold on to prayer, and the moment that you're praying, really, that God is at work, hold on to that as a realistic, actual thing. And in verse 24 today, but the word of God increased and multiplied. So through prayer, when the word of God is has come upon, that is when the field changes. The field of Ephesus was changed.
19장 8절에서 20절에 나온 내용이고요.
That was a passage in Book of Acts.
예수라는 유대인 거짓 선자인 마술사가 총독으로 믿지 못하게 하는데 거기에 복음이 전거됨으로 말미암아 총독이 예수 앞에 돌아오는 역사가 일어났어요.
And there was a magician named Bar Jesus, and he was blocking the gospel, but that forces of darkness was broken down, and you're able to see the commander receiving the gospel.
사도행 16장 16절 18절에 보면은
And if it's in Acts 16:16 through 18.
예수의 이름이 선포되어지니까 그 귀신이 떠나가고 복음이 전거되어지니
The demon-possessed servant girl, when the gospel was preached, the demon fled, and the gospel was preached in that land.
예수 그리스도 이름의 복음이 전거되어지는 현장들마다 점술과 우상과 귀신 문화가 무너지고 복음 문화가 이루어짐을 말하고
When through our prayers, when the gospel of Jesus Christ is proclaimed inside of the field, that is when all of idols, sorcery, and magicians all disappeared, and the kingdom of God is established there. There's no other way to break down the partisans of darkness inside of the field. We must only proclaim the gospel inside of that field, and the angel of the Lord must be mobilized, God must work on the, upon that place, and the partisan of light must be made to break down that partisan of darkness. It is same for us. If when other people criticize us, do you think we will change? Do you think we'll change if people nag at us? I'm sorry to say, but there's never a case. But when the word of God is proclaimed through the prayers, that is when our imprints and we receive healing. Our imprints change and we receive healing. That is why we must truly pray. Because the word of God is living and active, and it will be fulfilled in Hebrews 4:12. For the word of God is living and active, sharper than any edged sword, piercing to the division of soul and the spirit of joints and marrows, and discerning the thoughts and intention of the heart. In one word, the word of God is living and is being fulfilled. In Isaiah 55:3, it tells us, incline your ear and come to me here, that your soul may live. When we are inside of the work of God, the works arise for us to live forever. We must live holding on to the Word of God, and we must believe the Word of God. I'll come to the end of my words. Really receive the spiritual strength that God is trying to give you. That spiritual strength is not given to you by anything else. Only through prayer, when you are able to believe the Word of God, you are able to receive the spiritual strength that God gives us. Even now, accurately, God is giving us the word that we need, and He's fulfilling that word. That is why whenever we're receiving the word, we must take a look at how the word of God has a relation with my life. We must always think and find the plans of God, thinking, why did God give me this word? And that means that we are inside of the stream of the word. And every time the word is given to us, we must see how God is fulfilling that word. And I really hope that you guys go and see that work being fulfilled inside of your lives. Those who are inside of the works of God will absolutely conquer the world. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May this blessing be upon all of the Hana Church believers.
말씀 역사 속에 있는 전도 제자의 기도, 여러분 기도 제목들 붙잡으시고 함께.